Alright, I would like to play first. I gotta have to mulligan that hand. Ugh, this hand is horrendous as well. Do I keep this hand? I actually think I might be pitching this hand also. This hand doesn't do anything. A turn two Dark Confidant. I mean, I guess if you're getting Cabal Therapy a bunch, it's like okay, but I think I can do better. Alright, see, this hand at least can just win. I'm getting Leyline of the Voided or Leyline of Sanctity? Oh, I'm getting Chancellored. Alright, well, Chancellor's minorly annoying, but I guess that isn't too bad. I get to just play a Lotus Petal here and pay one for it. And then pass the turn. Don't think I want to play any of my other spells here because of Storm Counts. I don't think I'm getting Cabal Therapy for Lotus Petal or Lion's Eye Diamond on turn one. Alright, opponent discarding on turn one is my assumption here. Let's see what it is. Phantasmagorian. Oh, that is the card you want to discard. Ooh, there's the Infernal Tutor. Interesting. Lion's Eye Diamond. So I'm going to cast potentially Infernal Tutor here. I'm going to look for. I guess I could have just emptied the Warrens for a bunch, but I feel like that actually isn't great. I'd rather just do this. So I can now empty the Warrens for 10, 12, 12 goblins. Is 12 goblins good enough? My opponent does nothing. Next turn I attack on 8. It probably is, so let's. Land. Cast Infernal Tutor. And then respond sack this for red, sure. Let's go ahead and get empty the Warrens. And then. Empty all of the Warrens. Unfortunately, I didn't have any rituals, so getting Passed in Flames obviously didn't do a whole lot. Oh, getting 10 goblins, sorry. Or is it 12? Yeah, it, okay. 10 goblins, I guess I miscounted something. Oh, because I played the Lotus Petal on turn one, of course. I just saw the Lotus Petal and assumed it was relevant. Either way, this is decent, although if my opponent's bringing back a bunch of Nether Shadows this turn, that actually could be enough. We'll see. It depends how many Bridge from Blows and/or Dread Returns are around. All right. Well, I don't see any bridges yet, and this just goes onto the battlefield. Doesn't get sacrificed or anything. So three or more creature cards above it. So yeah, we get two Nether Shadows here, and let's see what the dredge hits. Come on, no bridges. Though bridge, I guess, actually isn't the end of the world. All right, hit a Dread Return. And Fairy Macabre, alright, that's one to know about. Bunch of Cabal Therapies, which don't do anything. I'm glad I went for it though, all those Cabal Therapies could have been trouble. Alright, so Nether Shadows come back, except if they trade in combat, they don't come back, and not a whole lot you can do this turn, so I guess I just get to attack for 10. I'm not drawing a whole lot of relevant spells here. There really is not much for me to to peel with 2 mana out and no cards in hand. All right, let's get in there, goblins. And if my opponent blocks, it does not block. Just takes it. It's just passed, but I don't think I want to play the land here. All right, you can dredge again, and let's see what you hit. All right, hit a bunch of crap. So now. My opponent hasn't had any Icarids or Narcomoebas or Bridge from Belows. Oh no, hit one Bridge from Below here. So that's interesting. So now there is one Dread Return, but one Dread Return's not quite lethal. No, there's a Balustrade Spy. So one Dread Return is lethal. The question is, how do you end up getting Nether Shadows into the graveyard? So you block, the Bridge from Below goes away, but then the Nether Shadows turn into creatures. And my opponent gets to bring them back with Phantasmagorian. So I should draw something here? There aren't very many things I could draw. Preordain. Alright. Find a Chain of Vapor. Alright. Ad Nauseam and Brainstorm. Interesting. Ad Nauseam does not do me a whole lot of good. So if I Brainstorm, I can draw Brainstorm and then fetch and then cast Brainstorm. So if I. Because Chain of Vapor, I think, is what I'm looking to get here. There's not a whole lot else that does anything, because if I don't attack, my opponent just gets to dredge and like just hit any Bridge from Below or an Narcomoeba and just win. If I do attack, my opponent blocks both, takes 8 going to 2, but then has 2 zombie tokens in play, and then discards Phantasmagorian and Stinkweed Imps and Golgari Grave Trolls and gets back, let's see, our cards. Alright, well, let's just put Brainstorm on top, since I think looking for Chain of Vapor seems like it's relevant. Alright, well, put back these, play Delta, sack Delta, getting, I guess, Volcanic at this point, and Cataxian Probe my opponent. Yeah, just to verify. Oh, there's a Fairy Macabre there. Alright. And you cast. Actually, my opponent can't put... Sorry, my opponent can't put this in the graveyard anymore, so... The Nether Shadows go away, but don't come back. So I don't actually just straight up lose here. Well, that's good to know. I don't think that's the case. There's only one Bridge from Below in the graveyard. So I get to attack with everything. My opponent just has to hit an Archimeba, basically. And has to block here so the Bridge doesn't get to survive. Alright. Three or more creature cards above it, so at this point my opponent's got two bridges in the... Oh no, the bridge triggers off my creature as well. Alright. I was worried for a second I missed a bridge or something. So now if my opponent hits a bridge from below, has to hit two bridges from below to go off, or an Archimeba. And if he does, I think I just lose, but if he does not, I should be victorious here. Wait, you can't... Was there another... Oh, there was another Phantasmagorian in hand? Alright, well, in that case I just lose, but I don't really think I have much of a choice there, since if I don't attack, my opponent hits too many different things to just win anyway. And would have hit the Narcomoeba to kill me in a similar fashion. Alright, so my opponent has dredged up a victory.